the Wonders of Africa project. I have more to say after this, and I want you to sit back and enjoy a little bit of the information that we have to share. Why haven't we traveled much in Africa? We depend on foreign radio stations. We depend on foreign televisions who tell us who we are. But this is an opportunity for us to communicate directly with each other, to know each other, to speak to each other, and market each other. And I think if we all agree that today is Kenya season, and 1,000 of us sell Kenya, we're able to give Kenya more destinations, more visitors than Kenya has ever had. If 1,000 of us decide to sell Uganda, we're able to give Uganda more tourists than ever had. So what we are trying to do is to pull the strength of Africa together. It's a combination and a coalition of the willing, bringing players from all over Africa so that we can talk about our destination. But the Wonders of Africa project is to expose the beauty of Africa, to expose the heritage of Africa, to expose everything about Africa to Africans. So my name is Ikechukwu. I will guide you, and I'm just one of the drivers of this project. So while we sit back and get to see each other's faces, I will want us to go straight to the major thing we are here. So I'll ask them to put on a video, and I want you to sit back and watch and read and understand, and we can talk after. Thank you.
Up and dust yourself off and back in the saddle. You're on the front line, everyone's watching. You know it's serious, we're getting closer, this is over. The pressure's on, you feel it, but you got it all, believe it. When you fold it up, oh, oh, and if you fold it up, eh, eh, tamina, mina, sangaiwa, cause this is Africa. Tamina, mina, eh, eh. This time for Africa. Listen to your guide, this is our motto. Your time to shine, don't wait in line. Y vamos por todo. People are raising their expectations. Go on and feed them, this is your moment, no hesitation. Today's your day, feel it. You pave the way, believe it. If you get down, get up, oh, oh. When you get down, get up, hey, hey. Tamina, mina, sangalewa. This time for Africa. Tamina, mina, hey, hey. Waka, waka, hey, hey. Tamina, mina, sangalewa. For Africa.
I'm well, I'm a journey, biggie, biggie, mama, one A to Z. My city's so sell, I'm a journey, biggie, biggie, mama, from east to west. My city, waka, waka, my A, A, waka, waka, my A, A. Tengu, sisa, mazimu, yeah. But this is Africa.
For Africa. choosing your battle. Pick yourself up and dust yourself off and back in the saddle. You're on the front line, everyone's watching. You know it's serious, we're getting closer, this isn't over. The pressure's on, you feel it. But you got it all, believe it. When you fall, get up, oh, oh. And if you fall, get up, eh, eh. Tamina, mina, sangalewa. Cause this is Africa. Tamina, mina, eh, eh. Waka, waka, eh, eh. Tamina, mina, sangalewa. This time for Africa. Our motto. Your time to shine, don't wait in line. If I must put over, people are raising their expectations. Go on and feed them, this is your moment, no hesitation. Today's your day, I feel it. You pave the way, believe it. You get down, get up, oh, oh. When you get down, get up, hey, hey. Tamina, mina, sangalewa. This time for Africa. Tamina, mina, hey, hey.
So sell my journey, biggie, biggie, mama, from east to west. My tea, waka, waka, my eh, eh. Waka, waka, my eh, eh, eh. Sing it, sister, my zimu, yeah. Cause this is Africa.
Thank you. Thank you. I hope you enjoyed that little clip. It explains to you the vision and what we are trying to achieve. We are trying to identify the 25 wonders of Africa. Over the next 2 years, each of the 6 zones of Africa are going to give us 4 must-visit destinations. Out of these 4, you add it together, it's going to give us 24. Then we have one that is already chosen. Out of the old wonders of Africa, the ancient wonders of Africa, two ancient wonders of the world, 2 we have found in Africa, the pyramids of Cheops and the lighthouse of Pharos, that's Alexandria. Only one is still standing today, the pyramids of Egypt in Giza. So that is a natural choice. So we are going to find 24 new sites to add to the pyramid. And we expect that in the future, every African, everybody of African descent should at least visit each one of those 25 sites. 4 will be in the diaspora, while 20 will be in Africa. And these things will be man-made and natural and amazing things. So we have put together a management team from different countries in Africa. The next video we are going to play is to show you who these leaders are. You can contact them if you are from any of those countries. Anybody in Africa who is interested in participating in this project is welcome. You can join us through your country rep. You can join us through a family page on Facebook, a group page you are going to form. So every single person in the world who has Africa at heart can be a part of this project. It will be broken into 5 different stages. But the most important thing today is we are going to introduce the team refs and the country leaders. Every country in Africa and the diaspora will be represented. So when you watch today, find out who is the team leader in your country. Some countries have three, some have four, some have five, some have one. Find out who the team leader is in your country or your region. Contact the person, and eventually the person will put you in a cohort. So the project starts from September and will end in 2022. So anything, I know some people don't understand English that well, so probably I'm speaking too fast. So what will happen is that you go through the publication, we are going to post it on Facebook, we are going to put it on YouTube, so we are going to post it everywhere, even on the website. You could go through it, read. Then when the Wonder starts properly, between September and November, everybody can contribute. Every African has to join in bringing out the best of Africa, selling Africa to Africans so that we can travel within Africa. I'm not saying that you shouldn't travel elsewhere, but make it your duty to travel within Africa. So we are going to introduce the country reps from the different countries in the world. So take your time, any country you come from, see the names, get to know them, and later you can contact them. If you cannot join or your country is not listed, you can contact us. We have the Wonders of Africa website. We have our social media handles, and you can always follow what we do. Remember, it's a two-year project. You can join at any time. If you are not here in the beginning, you can join at any time. Today is just the introduction of it. Next month, in August, we'll have another meeting where we'll share how far we have gone. So we are going to introduce the team leaders from all the countries that are already in. So why don't you sit back and get to know who these team leaders are? Thank you. Today is just the introduction of it. Next month, in August, we'll have another meeting where we'll share how far we have gone. So we are going to introduce the team leaders from all the countries that are already here. So why don't you sit back and get to know who these team leaders are. Thank you. Today is just the introduction of it. Next month, in August, we have another meeting where we'll share how far we have gone. So, give me freedom, give me fire, give me reason, take me higher. Be the champion, take the building, unify us, make us feel proud. In the season, heads are lifting.
Lifting. Like a waving flag.
We have 2 years to do this project, so there will be time for everybody. The target is to have 1,000 travel professionals from Africa and its diaspora to get involved in this project, to begin to drive a visit Africa, know Africa, enjoy Africa. And the Africa, I tell you, is the 6 zones of the African Union, which means we are going to go to our brothers and sisters in the Caribbean, and they are going to come here to us. I know some of the countries don't have reps. You can get across to us, and we'll be updating every other day on the website, on the social media handles. They are not active now because we are still putting together the infrastructure. To get 1,000 travel professionals of African descent is not something that we can do in a week or 2 weeks. We have been long at this thing for the past 4 months, and we are going to give Africa its best opportunity to showcase itself. So I'm going to ask each one of the representatives that we've appointed to speak and to us about what they are going to do in their region. It's like a goodwill, a remark from the different zones of Africa. They are going to speak in English. They are going to speak in French. They are going to speak in Swahili. They are going to speak in Portuguese. Africa has 6 languages. Nobody's going to speak Arabic today, and nobody's going to speak Spanish today. But in the, I know Hussein can speak Arabic for us. But in the coming months, we are going to have people from every part of Africa and its diaspora address us. Today is going to be a short 1 hour introduction, just an introduction. And we are going to put everything we have done today out there for you to see. We are open for questions. If you can ask me or reach me, you can reach the team leaders in your country. You can contact them and you can work with them. I can see that our lady in London is there smiling, Madam Caro. We'll come to you. So I would like to call on our French, I've spoken a lot of English. I want to call on our French-speaking lady from Benin Republic, Olama of Gota Voyage, to give us a little remark. Madam Olama, you can unmute your phone and talk.
Okay, thank you so much, our tourism ambassador, Mr. Ikechukwu. Thank you for this opportunity. I want to say also a great hello to everyone, my colleagues from all over the world, all over Africa, and why not all over the world. And then all the travel and tourism professionals joining us, all the travel stakeholders from all over the world. I am told to speak for just 1 minute. So I want to say what we've started doing immediately in Benin, because we found out that Benin has got so much to showcase to the world, but this has been over the years untapped. And this Wonders of Africa is a wonderful platform to really let us begin to speak about it. So what we've started doing, every Sunday evening by 8:30, we discover and showcase in a live Facebook program, we showcase one of the sites. We get our colleagues in Benin to already appreciate, you know, we put our heads together to see the next sites to put up across. It was so amazing. The one of last week was the safari destination of Benin. And I had a powerful tour operator from Nigeria that asked me, so you have a safari game drive site in Benin. That is the secret of Wonders of Africa. We are already showcasing and we'll continue to do that. We have already gotten all the tour operators, all the tourism stakeholders in Benin. They're all connected. Some of them are connected here because it was shared there. We will be working together to showcase the best of Benin, and we're very sure we will appear in 150 and 25. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Olama. We had expected you to speak in French for people who can't hear you, but you chose to speak in English.
I can do that. I can just for 2 seconds.
Okay, please go ahead, oblige us.
Okay, donc bonjour tout le monde. Je m'appelle Lola Mojuku. En fait, je suis la représentante de Wonders of Africa, les merveilles de l'Afrique au Bénin. Et ce que nous avons commencé par déjà faire à travers les merveilles de l'Afrique, c'est que chaque dimanche, soit à partir de 20h30, nous choisissons une destination qui doit émerveiller l'Afrique et le monde entier. Et cela, le dimanche passé, nous a amené vraiment à un autre niveau parce qu'on avait sorti la destination de safari qui s'appelle Safari Panjari National Park. Et au finish, tout le monde était « wow ». Les collègues du monde entier me disaient « mais est-ce qu'il existe une site de safari au Bénin ?» Et c'est juste parce que nous sommes aujourd'hui engagés dans Wonders of Africa que le monde entier sont en train de découvrir les sites qu'il peut découvrir au Bénin. Donc, je suis convaincue qu'avec mes collègues, les tour opérateurs et les acteurs du tourisme du Bénin, nous allons non seulement figurer dans les premiers 100, dans les deuxièmes 50 et également dans les 25. Je vous remercie. Thank you.
Thank you. Merci.
Pleasure.
I'll switch to English now. I'll ask Madam Carol all the way from UK to talk to us a little. Madam Carol, you are next.
Hello, can you hear me? I just had to unmute.
Yeah, we can hear you.
Yes, good afternoon, everyone. It's a pleasure to be a part of this initiative. My background is that I am British born of Jamaican parents. And I run my own tourism agency in the United Kingdom doing marketing and tourism development. My main client is the Caribbean. So I work very, very close with the Caribbean, but I've been fortunate for many years that I have had the opportunity to work closely with Africa. And last year I had an opportunity to lead a Caribbean delegation to Accra, and we really participated. And I see that my friend Sharon Palacio from Belize is also on this call. So absolutely honored to be a part of it. And really, I see myself having two hats. One is with working with the diaspora here in the United Kingdom, but also as well reaching out to the Caribbean, because I have such a strong reputation and integrity in the Caribbean. I myself am the direct descendants of enslaved people that left Africa and went to live in the Caribbean, direct descendants. And therefore, for me to have the opportunity to engage with Africa is really important. And the way how the world is going and the issues globally that we're having with Black lives and the whole campaign that we're feeling right now about Black lives and how much they matter. I believe strongly that if people really know their heritage, their culture, and the wonders of Africa, it will have a far-reaching impact on the generations that are getting further and further away from their heritage. So to me, this project, it's not only about tourism. It is about bringing the diaspora closer to home and really allowing the diaspora to understand that Africa is a part of them and how they can embrace it, identify, and learn. For too long, the diaspora, particularly those of Caribbean heritage, we have been separated from Africa. And I say to all my African friends, it is time to open your arms and bring your people home. They need you more than you will ever realize. And when I see the young people in the United Kingdom and they're not really understanding who they are, where they're from, and that there is something deeper to them, I say to Africa once again, bring your people home. Thank you.
Thank you. That was very passionate, very, very strong. Thank you, Madam Carol. That was amazing. And we are going to call our sister from Angola. You can choose to speak in Portuguese because I know the others are listening to you. We'll call Angela now to speak to us from all the way from Angola. Angela. Okay. While we are waiting for Angela, I can see Madam Sharon. Madam Sharon, can you say hi? Say one or two things to us. All the way from Belize. I know it's early morning in Belize. Apologies for having to wake you up this early. Unmute Sharon. Yeah. Unmute. Go ahead, speak. Unmute. Aha. Can you hear? Unmute again.
Greetings from Belize.
Okay, I can hear you now.
Pleasant good morning from Belize to one and all. I see my friend Carol, Brother Ikechi. Thanks so much. For me, this is a golden opportunity to be able to sit on this platform. I've been privileged to attend Aquaba, and for me, that cemented my passion, my love for Africa, and passionate about sharing to my fellow Belizeans and Belizeans in the diaspora, the beauty, the wonders of Africa. So without further ado, I must say a million thanks, and I'm definitely looking forward to meeting everybody and taking wonderful tours to Africa and for Africans to come to Belize. The name of my tour company is Belafrica, and that was created after my wonderful, satisfying, memorable participation at Aquaba. Thank you. In my language, we say sereme.
Thank you. Hussein, I have to call you now. So let's hear Jambo all the way from Nairobi, Kenya.
Hello and Jambo to all from magical Kenya. It's nice to see all some of my colleagues here, you know, from different countries, like Walter from Zambia, of course, Ikechi, and all the other guys from the platform as well. I think this is a wonderful opportunity, and we're looking forward to seeing how best we can work together. Kenya, of course, is a very potential country, you know, for other African nations to actually travel to Kenya. One of the things that you must know is that one of our largest, our second largest international source market is actually Uganda, which is just our neighboring country, right after the US. So you can actually see that this is such a good potential to grow the Africa tourism, and looking forward. I'm a tourist myself as well, even though I run a travel company. I've traveled to some of your countries. And I'm looking forward to, you know, sending our clients from Kenya to, you know, different parts of Africa, and also the other African nations coming to magical Kenya, where we're ready to welcome you. Asante. Thank you.
Thank you, Hussein. And that's from magical Kenya. And I'm happy you brought out the fact that Uganda is your second largest source market. That's what we want to do for the whole of Africa. So I want to call on Walter all the way from Zambia to say a word to us. I see that you're in a car.
Hello, good afternoon. My name is Walter, all the way from Zambia. I run a company called Sea Adventures and Tours. It's a truly Zambian-owned company. And I have always been working with people like Hussein from Kenya, Raju from Tanzania, Bani from Africa. So it's a great time and chance to also encourage our African brothers to travel within Africa and spend the money within Africa. Zambia can say it's a hidden gem. It's got a lot to offer. It has not been known because Zambia was depending more on the copper mining. But now we're going from mining into sustainable tours. So we've got a lot to offer. We've got the Big Falls, we've got the great culture, we've got lots of wildlife. So please, let's work together and promote travel within Africa. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you all the way from Zambia. Is Angela ready now to talk to us in Portuguese? Angela, are you ready? Want to hear you speak Portuguese today? Okay, we'll go to Ghana. And Charlie, our big guy, Ahmed. Hi, hi, Skumasi, can you speak? Can you talk to us, Ahmed?
Yes. Yes, good afternoon, Ikechi, and all my brothers and sisters on the platform. It's been my utmost pleasure to be with you this afternoon. I look forward to welcome you in my beautiful country, Ghana. Kumasi, I come from Kumasi. Kumasi is the Ashanti, falls in the Ashanti region of Ghana, where we call it the heartbeat of Ghana culture. I can't wait to receive you here and show you our immense and massive cultural displays in this region. You will have the feel of the real African culture when you come to Kumasi, Ghana. I want you to wear Ghana like what I do. This is kente. I have one for every one of you when you visit Ghana, certainly. And you eat Ghana, you wear Ghana, and you see Ghana, and you will certainly love Ghana. I want to assure my brother Ikechi and the rest of the team, my colleagues here, Ambassador Nancy Sam and my brother Kwame Ansong of Sun Seekers will be my team leaders. Mm-hmm. We'll work hand in hand and we will certainly make Ghana and Africa proud. Thank you, Ikechi, for the opportunity.
Thank you, Ahmed. I want to call on the chairman of POT, chairman of Remlords from Nigeria. Mm-hmm. He's the chairman of the Board of Trustees for Tour Operators. Can you speak to us?
Hello, Ikechi friends. Are you hearing me?
We can hear you.
Yeah, I want to say thank you for this platform. I also see that this is the climax of what you've been driving over the years. And many years ago, 10 years ago, I heard you talk about the fact that Africa is our oyster. And today we're practically seeing Africans connect. So I'd like to salute all Africans that are on the platform this afternoon. And to appreciate the good effort. I'd like to say to everyone, welcome to the wonders of Africa. We'd like to appreciate the fact that you chose us, myself, Shehi, and Wonu to lead Nigeria. And we're going to show our colleagues in Africa that Nigeria is safe and is accessible. Ghana will say, come and see Ghana, eat and wear. But we're going to say, come see Africa, wear Africa, eat Africa, visit Africa, know Africa, enjoy Africa. We'd like to thank you for this platform. We look forward to the expedition. I've been part of the Nigerian Wonders, so I have a bit of experience. We're going to be able to coordinate our colleagues in Nigeria and to make sure that the expedition is worth it and to expose Africans to what Nigeria has to offer. The most populous nation in Africa has a lot. And I'd like to let you know that you are also safe coming here when you are led by, you know, trained tour operators and all of that. We'd like to thank you for this platform and greet everybody. Welcome to Africa. Thank you.
Thank you. All the way from South Africa, my big guy, Tabiso. Can we hear from you? Unmute yourself. Unmute. Tabiso, unmute your phone.
I'm trying that. Am I muted?
Go ahead, we can hear you.
Greetings, my brothers. Greetings, my South my sisters. First of all, I want to say, yes, I'm South African, but I'm an African. For me, this platform represents what I've dreamt about. I've always heard about the United States of America. When is it time that we form the United States of Africa? When I grew up as a history student, I was told Africa is the dark continent. Well, it's time we show the world we are not the dark continent. Us as a collective are the light to make that continent bright. Whatever you find in the world, you will find in my continent, Africa. Come to South Africa. It's history. It's beaches. It's a rich history. It does not belong to us. At some point, when apartheid was hitting us, Africa accommodated us. We are one. I'm not South African, I'm an African. And I'm looking forward to telling the world, come to Africa and experience what we are. When you go to Europe, you go to different countries, Italy, Germany, to spread your dollar. I'm also saying when you come to Africa, come to South Africa, go to Ghana, go to Kenya, go to all these places and see who we are, because we are the richest nation in the world. We might be black, but we are God's brightness. Africa is a place to be.
Thank you, my brother. Thank you. That was wonderful. I like the vision. Power, wisdom, and a lot of passion comes from South Africa. And we are happy to have you out here. My brother DJ Fayeye is going to speak. Then we'll show you another clip before we round up. We want it to be just 1 hour. So DJ, you're welcome. Go ahead.
Thank you. Good afternoon, Africa. Bon après-midi. Boa tarde, Africa. Well, just trying the multitask skills. This is such a great news that Africa is gathered here to discuss African matters. I've received and I've heard a lot of people complaining to the fact that European Union and including Dubai, apparently, but the Dubai list is still to be confirmed. A lot of countries are restricted, almost all of Africa, excluding one, two, or three countries in Africa. And people are complaining. And when I look at all this, I just laugh, because there is absolutely nothing we can do as Africa if we come together. My message has been, since this lockdown and during this COVID-19 pandemic, all Africans should travel Africa. Let's make this possible by 2022, have a minimum of 3 million Africans to travel in Africa. To give you just an idea how great this would be, an average tourist spend about $500 on average. If we have a minimum of 3 million times 500, that is how much Africa would have made on top and above any other visitors who would have visited Africa. It's really not a crisis that Africa is told not to travel to Europe. It's not a crisis. It is for us an eye opener and an opportunity to excel as Africa. Yeah, so we're waiting for you. We are here in Mzanzi, in the tail of Africa, in South. Welcome. Thank you.
Thank you. DJ, and we are going to show you a little bit of what we did before, but I want to make sure that we don't pass 1 hour. So we have a few minutes left, and I want you to remember this. If you don't know how to contact us, in the chat, put in your email. We are going to get across to you. We are going to get across to everybody. We are going to show you again what this vision is about. We are going to post, if you keep watching, even when we have ended, we are going to play back again the team leaders. So if you don't know who the leader in your country is, look at it again. But let's share with you again And in the next 2 years, we are going to showcase Africa like never before. We are building a coalition of 400 to 1,000 travel professionals to market Africa to Africans and its diaspora. They are going to be the most potent force in travel and tourism. Something like this have never happened. We needed AU to put together the aviation, it hasn't worked. We needed AU to put together the trade, it hasn't worked. But we are the coalition of the willing, and we are going to show them how we roll in Africa. So once again, sit back and enjoy this bit. Thank you.
Choosing your battle, pick yourself up and dust yourself off and back in the saddle. You're on the front line, everyone's watching. You know it's serious, we're getting closer, this isn't over. The pressure's on, you feel it, but you got it all, believe it. When you fold it up, oh, oh, and if you fold it up, eh, eh, cause this is Africa. Time for Africa. Listen to your guide. This is our motto. Your time to shine. Don't wait in line. It's almost for todo. People are raising their expectations. Go on a feed and this is your moment, no hesitation. Today's your day, feel it. You pave the way, believe it. If you get down, get up, oh, oh. When you get down, get up, hey, hey. Tamina, mina, sangalewa. This time for Africa. Tamina, mina, hey, hey. Waka, waka, hey, hey. Tamina, mina, sangalewa.
no hesitation. Today's your day, feel it. You pave the way, believe it. If you get down, get up, oh, oh. When you get down, get up, hey, hey. Tamina, mina, sangalewa. This time for Africa. Tamina, mina, hey, hey. Waka, waka, hey, hey. Tamina, mina, sangalewa.
Thank you. I can see Kitty Pope there, all the way from America. How are you, Kitty? Nice to have you. And we have to round up today because I promised it was going to be 1 hour. This is the first time we are doing this. So the next time in August will be a little longer, and we allow all our leaders to make presentation. So I thank all of you. If you notice, we showed Festac 77, the anthem, and the image. Because the last time Africa and its diaspora did anything like this was in 1977. During Festac, the whole Africa came together. Then the other time we had that, we had one in 2010 in South Africa as the Africa's World Cup. So what we are doing today, the start of Wonders of Africa, will be the second time we are going to bring all the energies of Africa, the sons of Africa, the children of Africa all over the world to drive a project all the way to the end. So I thank you for being part of us. We are all going to win together. We are going to do this together, and we are going to meet again in the coming days. So what I'm going to do now, we are going to show you the national team leaders. So please, as we are signing off, why don't you sit back and watch and understand who the team leader for your territory is. More countries will be added as you move on. So I thank you for being with me today. Till we meet again in August. Thank you.
Like a waving. feel down. Unify us, make us feel proud. In the streets, our heads are lifting. As we lose our inhibition, celebration, it surrounds us. Every nation, all around us, sing forever young. Singing songs underneath the sun. Let's rejoice in the beautiful game. And together at the end of the day, we all sing. When I get older, I will be stronger. They'll call me freedom, just like a wave. When I get older, I will be stronger. They'll call me freedom, just like a wave.
Thank you.